Hi everyone, my name is Stefan, I'm a pulmonologist, and in this video I'd like to really just give you a couple of tips on how to use percussion. Percussion is this thing that doctors do. So this is a really critical skill, a critical clinical examination skill that I believe most doctors should have in their arsenal, in their skill box. Basically, you are trying to generate a sound and to compare right to left and top to bottom, to try to determine where the pathology, the thing that you're interested in, might be. So for example, you may be trying to find the upper border of the liver, or you may be trying to find the upper border of an effusion. You would percuss the backside. So there are many, many things you can do with percussion. It's still a very useful clinical skill to have. It's not only limited to the chest, of course. You may use it for your abdomen, but then the sound would be different, as you can hear, hopefully. Versus the chest, versus if I'm percussing on my leg, it sounds dull. So I'm not sure if you could hear that with the microphone being so far away from it. But basically, I would like to go now and show you how to do it by changing the camera over to a table, and you can see where I'm actually percussing on my hand. How do I keep my hand in place in order to get a good sound? So basically, what you're trying to do is get a strong enough sound with percussion. Obviously, this is done over the desk, so it will sound amplified. So obviously, it won't sound like this on a patient, but it's a good way to practice on a desk to see if you're getting a good enough sound. Because I struggled with this when I was trying to learn how to percuss effectively, and I've heard this from other medical students as well. And it's something that is good to get the technique down as soon as possible. So the main problem with percussion, and the reason why many people don't really get a good enough sound, a strong enough sound, is because there isn't a good seal between your palm and the surface you are percussing. So if your hand is loose, the sound will not be good enough. What you're trying to get is this finger on which you're actually percussing to be in very tight contact with the surface you are percussing. So basically, now you will get a strong enough sound. If I let it loose, it won't be nearly as strong enough. So obviously the table amplifies everything, but this is the same principle that applies when you're doing it on a patient. Now, one thing that many people struggle with is they're trying to get the finger really down like this, and it sounds well enough on a table, but on a patient it's not really comfortable. It's actually a little bit painful here for you to do it, and it's uncomfortable for the patient as well, because you are really pressing a small area in their skin, so it's not going to be comfortable for the patient. So what you're trying to get is the whole palm to rest on the patient's skin and just press firmly so that you have a good seal. And then you should have a good percussion wherever you are actually percussing, but generally it will be your fingers. So basically, step one is, like I said, to get a good seal. So you get a good seal, your whole palm together. Generally, if you put your fingers together and you have the whole palm resting there, it's easier for you, it's easier for the patient. Just needs to be firmly sealed here and here as well. Now, step two for percussion is really what happens with your hand that's actually doing the percussion stroke. So what you're aiming to do is basically have your hand act like some sort of a hammer. So basically you have to have a hammer action. But you shouldn't be doing it from the fingers like this. It should be coming from the wrist. So it should have all the weight of your hand just dropping on a specific spot, the tip of your finger, usually this one. So like I say, as you can see here, it comes from the wrist. If I do it like this, it's just not the same. If I do it with the whole arm, it's just, you need to keep everything firm. So basically what I would recommend is you do it from the wrist. So basically this is the movement you're after. Pam. Pum, 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 pum. So this is basically percussion. Have a firm seal and then percuss from your wrist while keeping everything else in your hand, your fingers, nice and firm. So really, really important to actually generate a strong enough sound. It's less important how you do it, how you keep your hand in place. As long as you get a good seal and you have a good stroke, it should all be fine and it should all come together and will help you and serve you well throughout your career. Hope this was helpful. And if you have any other questions that for, you know, future videos, do leave them in the comment section below. I'll see you in future videos. All the best.